Hey, church family, I wanted to take this opportunity to present you with another word of encouragement as we prayerfully prepare for tomorrow's inauguration. Now, as we transition our focus from remembering and memorializing Martin Luther King Jr. now to the 2021 inauguration tomorrow, I'm sure that we've all seen videos of our National Guard fortifying the Capitol grounds right there in D.C. There's currently a militarized green zone surrounding the nation's Capitol building, which is being guarded by upwards of 25,000 armed troops. According to the reports that I've heard, you know, there are currently 10 times as many troops on the ground in D.C. than we have stationed in Iraq and Afghanistan combined. It's also interesting to note that the National Guard has erected a 20-mile wall surrounding the Capitol, which includes razor wire and barricades and military checkpoints. With that being the case, I can't help but to remember a statement that Nancy Pelosi made back in 2017 when she declared, "The Democrats do not support the wall." She's talking about our border wall, of course, but she went on to share her own opinion about that wall by declaring, "The wall is, in my view, immoral, expensive, and unwise." Okay, so let me get this straight. One security or secure military wall, which is located at our nation's border, that wall, that's immoral. But the security wall that you just erected around the Capitol, that is a moral wall. I'm curious, what is the basis? What is the basis for believing that one security wall is immoral and the other security wall is morally correct and righteous? I'll wait to maybe find out what the basis for making those decisions is. I can't figure it out myself, but she went on to insist that the border wall is not only immoral, but that it's expensive. Of course, there's no doubt about that. A border wall running along our southern border, clearly expensive, but we must not fail to remember that Nancy Pelosi, she doesn't have a problem spending America's money. She's the one who has been pushing forward this omnibus bill, which totals $1.4 trillion, which includes billions and billions of dollars for foreign aid. There's in this omnibus bill, there's $500 million allocated for Jordan and $33 million for Venezuela. The bill includes a $25 million package for Pakistan, $86 million for Cambodia, $130 million for Nepal, $135 million for Burma, $453 million for the Ukraine, $700 million for the Sudan, and the list just goes on and on and on. Clearly, Nancy Pelosi is not worried about spending America's money on the expensive things that she wants. Another example is found in the fact that they're currently spending $45 million in order to fortify the Capitol there in D.C. for this inauguration, and part of that money is going to a temporary wall and all of the troops necessary to secure the Capitol grounds. And what this means is that they don't mind the expense so long as it's a security wall that they want. Finally, I would remind you that Nancy Pelosi not only insisted that it was immoral and expensive to build a wall, but she also insisted that the Democrats don't support the border wall because it's unwise. Unwise. Now, it's not my point to defend the border wall. You might like a border wall on our southern border. You might not. It's not my point here to defend it or argue against it. No, instead, I only mean to point out that it just strikes me as strange that those who insist that, border walls are unwise are quick to erect security walls the minute that they feel insecure. The minute that they want more security, they think it's very wise to erect a security wall. So why is one security wall unwise and the other one is wise? We see a similar hypocrisy in the actions of those who call for the defunding of the police, but then the very minute their life is being threatened, they're quick to call 911. They want to defund the police at one point until they don't feel safe, and then they want all the police that will come and help them. How about those who are calling for more gun restrictions while at the same time relying on the fully armed security detail, which provides them with all the protection that they need? They don't want guns for you, but they want guns for the people in their security detail. And now think about that for a moment. We're actually paying taxes, which pay the, provide a paycheck for anti-gun politicians so that, they have the money to enjoy a fully armed security detail. Why don't we just keep those taxes and pay for our own security detail? I don't think they would go for that. Just to sum it all up, listen, those who insist that security walls are immoral, expensive, and unwise, they don't actually believe it. They don't. They don't believe it. And the proof of my point can be seen today right there at our nation's capital. Those who spoke against the border wall on our southern border here in America were quick to erect a security wall around the Capitol for their own protection. The Biden-Harris transition team has shown us that security walls are good, cost-effective, and wise. Or to put it in the words of Joe Biden, folks, I voted for a fence. I voted, unlike most Democrats, and some of you won't like it, I voted for 700 miles of fence. That's what Biden said back in 2006. He was actually bragging about his support for the border wall after he voted for the Secure Fence Act of 2006. Now, as the security wall around the Capitol goes up in preparation for tomorrow's inauguration, you know, President-elect Joe Biden has already promised to dismantle the border wall that he actually voted for back in 2006. And while I'm all for the legal immigration of those who want to come and help make our nation the incredible melting pot that it is, you know, it's also important for us to realize that security walls are essential for our nation's security. In order to prove my point, I would just appeal to a statement that Joe Biden himself made back in 2006 when he said this. He says, "Let me tell you something, folks. People are driving across that border with tons of everything from byproducts for methamphetamine to cocaine to heroin, and it's all coming up through corrupt Mexico." I didn't say that. Don't get mad at me. That's what Joe Biden said back in 2006, and he was right. To prove that he still believes in the effectiveness and morality of border walls, well, we only need to look as far as the Capitol grounds today, where we find a security wall with fully armed soldiers ready to defend the Capitol. Listen, I'm all for it. I see no problem with them putting up that security wall. I see no problem with them surrounding the Capitol with soldiers today for the security of those who are there. And I also see no problem with a border wall on our southern border, just as Joe Biden promised to provide us back in 2006. Finally, I would remind you that border walls are not immoral because we certainly see the Lord endorsing border walls in the New Jerusalem. It's actually Revelation chapter 21 where we learn that the New Jerusalem has a great and high wall with 12 gates and 12 angels at the gates and names written on them, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. 3 gates on the east, 3 gates on the north, 3 gates on the south, 3 gates on the west. Now the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and on them were the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. Christian, listen, the New Jerusalem is going to be surrounded by a border wall complete with 12 gates. And while it's true that the gates are going to be open to those who trust in Jesus Christ, it's also true that there shall by no means enter it anything that defiles or causes an abomination or a lie, but only those who are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Now, in light of this, we can see that those who want to pass the border walls of the New Jerusalem, their name must be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And how do we have our name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Well, we trust in Jesus Christ. With that being the case, let's go in and preach the gospel message of Jesus Christ. Let's preach the gospel of Jesus Christ so that we can encourage unbelievers to trust in Jesus so that their name might be written in the Lamb's Book of Life and so that they can enter freely into the New Jerusalem. Let's go out and preach the gospel message of Jesus Christ so that we can all be accepted as legal immigrants of the New Jerusalem. And until we find ourselves walking through those pearly gates, let's continue fighting the good fight of faith, all for the glory of God.